Hey besties, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, go ahead and click that subscribe button, click that bell. You just gained a new best friend. If you want to know just how orientation went at USUHS, stick around. Let's get into it. Know me, my name is Alexis Russell. I am prior enlisted in the Navy, did 10 years, and now I'm currently an MS1 at USUHS. So we are about to get into what orientation was like. So our orientation was 3 weeks. We actually started on August 3rd, and it was 3 weeks because as a medical student at USUHS, you have a dual role. You are an officer in your prospective branch, as well as a medical student. So they had to break down each of those roles throughout the 3 weeks, as well as get into the curriculum that we'll be learning at USU. The first week was completely made up understanding the military aspect of a medical student at USU. So throughout this week, we did various activities to make sure that we understood who we need to contact as far as military aspects go, what is actually expected of us as an officer in our prospective branches, as well as any other miscellaneous things that comes with being in the military while going to medical school. So the first day, all the branches kind of went along with each other to carry out the first day activities. A lot of team building, a lot of networking, meeting our classmates, playing team building games. I do have a first day video. If you are interested in seeing that, please click the video link in the description, and that'll take you to the first day at USU. The rest of the week, we split up into our prospective branches and we carried out the activities in order to fulfill what was necessary as an officer in those branches. So that included meeting our company commander. We also did a uniform inspection to make sure that you're wearing your uniform correctly. A lot of individuals do attend the officer development school prior to coming to USU. However, you know, that is only a 5-week course, so it's great to have some prior service individuals there to assist the people who are just coming in the military, may not know certain things about the uniform. So the uniform inspection is great to give them perspective of what's expected of them. We also did our photographs. The Navy, we did our photographs in khakis, which is the khaki shirt and khaki pants. I have a picture of here so you can see what I'm referring to. We had a introduction to the computer lab and the LRC, which the LRC stands for the Learning Resource Center. You will come to know that I'm going to be using a lot of acronyms throughout this time in medical school because that's what the military does. They use a lot of acronyms. So I'm going to try to catch myself when I use one again and explain what it is. But if I don't, please forgive me. So yes, we got an introduction to the LRC. The LRC is basically like a library. If you need resources for research, or if you just need a book to coordinate with whatever topic you're going through in class, that's a place to go to, as well as computer lab there to be able to print. So it's definitely a great utility for us while we're here at the medical school. And then that day, we ended with IT registration. Now, there are certain things that you have to go through to make sure that you have access to the computers. We have CAC cards, and that allows us access. So we went through IT registration to make sure that we can actually log on to the website, log into Sakai, which is the program that we will be utilizing throughout our time here to find our course curriculum, find our work assignments, and find out where we're supposed to be. So yeah, a brief introduction to that. And then throughout the rest of the day, we carried out individual transitional tasks. Now that can include making appointments for dental, medical, that include checking in other places. If you did not have a CAC card, then getting your CAC card done. So whatever necessary tasks you need, they made sure to implement enough time for us to take care of that stuff. So by the time we actually do start this upcoming Monday, we were ready and didn't have to worry about these miscellaneous tasks. So we carried on with the rest of the week. A lot of briefs, a lot of learning aspects as far as rank and recognition on both the enlisted and the officer side. So it's just really making sure that the individuals that are just coming in that do not have no prior experience, never been in the military. They understand how to address other individuals they may come across in the military, and know what their rank, how to address them. We ended up finishing with access to some of the programs we have to get into, as far as NCIVS, as far as My Navy Portal. So we were given a brief on that. And like I said, all this stuff is just preliminary to make sure that you can access everything you need to be successful on the military side, because there are things that are going to be expected of us on our military side, even though we are currently in training status, just to keep up to date. And that's things such as training, physical fitness, you know, medical and dental. So that was basically what that week consisted of, as far as getting these individuals acclimated to the military, showing us resources that we can use to either look up how to wear our uniforms, how to access our records when it comes to dental or medical, who to talk to, where our chain of command is, who our chain of command is. So I think it was a great way to get the people caught up who are, this is, like I said, this is brand new to them. There are a few of us who are prior service, so this wasn't really anything new to us that was stated that week, but that was basically the first week. All right, let's get into week two. So week two is dedicated to the academic side of it. Remember, like I said earlier, you are in a dual role when you go to USU as a medical student. You are an officer as well as a medical student. So week two was all dedicated about the medical student aspect of it. So we met OSA, which OSA stands for Officer Student Affairs. Talking with OSA, we had the opportunity to watch a round panel discussion on diversity, and they brought some of the medical students there who have dealt with some adversity or maybe have, you know, diversity that they wanted to talk about. And it was great because we actually was able to act as like a fly on the wall to see them discuss some of these topics when it comes to diversity. We moved on to a reading that the class was expected to read together called An Inclusive Leader. Great read. I definitely encourage you to check it out if you do have the time. But the synopsis of it was basically learning how to take yourself from being unaware to being an advocate when it comes to diversity and inclusiveness in any field, right? So definitely a great read. We broke out into groups and discussed our perspective on it, discussed some maybe the challenges that we went through in our lives, continued to talk about student success and academic grit, and some other things as far as the resources that we had to make sure that our family was sustained as well, which is the Fleet and Family Services. They gave us a brief to let us know that, you know, we're not here by ourselves. We have options to assist, whether that be our family, looking for housing, looking for care for our children, just really giving us all the extra resources that are offered to us. We ended up finishing the week out with going over the student handbook, as well as meeting the student government and getting an opportunity to see what positions may be open for us in the coming weeks when it is time for student elections, as well as identifying what is expected in each role as a student government individual. But once again, this week was very encompassing of just the academic side of the house and really gearing us up for our final week in orientation. All right, let's get into the final week of orientation. So on the Navy side of things, we actually started the week off by meeting Dr. Keller, who explained to us all the specialties in the Navy and actually how it works on getting matched. He explained where we're lacking at and as far as where we're overmanned. So the biggest takeaway I want you guys to get from this is the fact that the Navy does not choose your specialty, okay? They have an array of specialties, and it's based on how well you do in medical school as well as how well you do in your exam. So please dismiss any rumors or myths that you have heard that says the Navy is going to select your specialty, because that's not true, okay? And I'm going to come to you guys with the facts. All right, moving on. So the next day we actually were virtual, and they went over exactly how to use the programs that we'll be using while we're in medical school, from Google Meets to Zoom to Sakai to any other resources that may be important while we are doing virtual. Now with USU, they already had given the option to learn virtually prior to COVID. They just kind of refine that to make sure that they're putting out the best product and making it easy accessible for the students. But there was already an option to be virtual with USU, so it wasn't a hard transition for them. So we got an introduction to what is going to be expected of the resources that we'll be needing to be successful in the virtual side of that. From there, we talked about some extracurriculars that we can get into, whether that be a special interest group, whether that be some curriculum that we feel is lacking in the medical curriculum that we're currently learning, and if we want to implement that. For example, a student from the previous year implemented a Spanish medicine curriculum, which I think was amazing because I personally would like to learn Spanish while I'm in medical school so I can be of an aid to Spanish-speaking patients. After that, we moved to the location where we will be taking our MBME test and explained how it would work, how it would be sitting, what is expected of us. And then we concluded with the week of an introduction to the curriculum and foundations of medicine. We were given a syllabus that actually details what is expected of us, what are we getting out of this class once we finish, as well as a day-to-day agenda of what we're going to be doing in class. So I definitely appreciate getting these syllabuses and seeing what is expected of me each day. We got one for both of the classes that we're in for foundation medicine, which is the foundation medicine on the science part of it, and then as well as physicians in society. And this is great because we're going to be interacting with patients the first week of medical school. How cool is that? We were given our books. We were given about 30 books weighing 130 pounds. Rest in peace to my back. But yes, weighing 130 pounds, all of our books. And if you don't know, all of our books are free as a student at USU. So we got first aid, we got BRS, any book that the average medical school student is getting, we got. And I'm definitely excited to jump into, you know, those books and start making my highlights and my notes. But that is the conclusion of our orientation. So I'm going to end this video with just kind of giving you guys my approach on how I'm going to tackle all of this. It looks like on average we're going to have about 4 to 5 lectures to get through every day, on top of some labs or some in-person groups activities, or maybe an in-person visit with some patients. So for now, my goal is to be one step ahead in the process, and that is reviewing the PowerPoints or PDFs that may be assigned for that next day, the day before, because I'm trying to make use of this PASS system where you see it multiple times before the actual exam. So my first pass will be the day before, and that's just me looking over the PDF, getting an idea of like what we're going to be talking about that next day. Then the second pass will be me actually watching the videos on the information that the school has given to us access to. They're already recorded lectures, so I'm going to go through with the PowerPoints and take my notes and write down questions, and that will be my second pass. And then my third pass will be using a third party, maybe Boards and Beyond or Sketchy if it applies, and you know, getting that information in a 5 to 6 minute video, and then eventually doing my fourth pass, which is Anki and utilizing the flashcards. So that's how I'm going to approach this first module. I'm definitely keeping an open mind, but for those medical students out there, my advice I can say is just take it day by day. It's a lot of information. It definitely can be overwhelming. So I think if you start to look too far into the future, it can be a lot. So please get a schedule going. Put everything you need to do on that day. If you're a person that needs to check it off, write it down in the agenda and do that. But the best advice I can give you is just get organized and just take it day by day. And I will keep you guys updated. So my goal to make sure that you guys are getting that insight of a medical student at USU, as well as this not being too much of an overwhelming extracurricular for me, is probably doing 2 videos a module. Our modules last anywhere from 7 to 8 weeks. So I'm planning on doing a video when my midterm is finished, and then doing a video after my final. So if you guys have questions, please don't ever hesitate to email me at becoming.dr.russell@gmail.com, or slide me in my DM on my IG. It may take me a little bit to get there because this is definitely my focus now, but I'll definitely get back to you with an answer. But I hope this is helping you out. If you're interested in going to USU, I definitely hope that I'm answering those questions that may not be available out there right now. But hey, stick around. Thank you for following my journey. And you guys all have a wonderful rest of your week. Thank you.